biblical parable of Goliath and David is familiar to all. Goliath, we also call him as Goliath. Goliath is a giant, around 6 feet 9 inches, heavily armored, a Philistine warrior challenging Israel. On the other hand, David, an adolescent with a normal physique, was a shepherd who was pitted against the mighty Goliath. Whether he made it to the battlefront by his choice or chance, we have many stories around. The Goliath-David parable is a metaphor to me. Each one of us have our own Goliath and David within us. Before explaining who our Goliath is, let me explain about our ego in a very simple way. Ego enables us to perceive, reason out, make our judgments and decisions, and store knowledge. It is the executive agent of our personality. So, it is important to each one of us. In common usage, many of us misuse this word. Okay, now let's look at two more terms. One is egotist and the other is egocentric. Egotist is a person who excessively believes in one's own importance. You have seen many of our leaders in public life and in organization life who show this trait without any shame. Egocentric people are those who cannot understand any other perspective apart from their own. These people carry a tendency to think they are always right and others always are wrong. They don't even stop to think that they could be also wrong. This egotist and the egocentric person within us are our Goliaths. Now, let us look at David. David was considered as an underdog, weak, even though he was not. A shepherd carries always a slingshot, confused as to why in the first place he was sent to fight with Goliath. However, he still defeated Goliath and won the fight. The David in us is also not a giant, but a person who holds many a time, surrounded by doubts, or likes to be constantly under the warmthness of Goliath, or appears sometimes as a casual visitor. David is our ego, which is engulfed by the giant egotism and egocentricity. Our David hardly fights with our Goliath because of the above said self-doubt in us. Now, let's get back to the parable. Was the battle won by David because of his strength or Goliath's weakness? Let me offer my perspective. Most of us do not know that Goliath suffered from a disorder called acromegaly. That made him as a giant. This disorder leads a person to develop large bones, thereby becoming very tall, and also causes nearsightedness, not allowing them to see too far out. Similarly, egotism and our egocentricity is also a disorder, which makes us to believe and behave like a giant. Narcissism, or over self-admiration, dominance and constant bickering with others are all result of this. Ego, however, is something we need to develop. Psychologists, hypnotists and counselors use ego strengthening as a therapeutic tool to develop one's self-confidence and other personal development. So, ego is not something to be considered as a destructive or noxious as commonly believed. Now you know that this. What are you waiting for? Awaken the David within you and kill your Goliath. Come on, David.